The men's slalom was the last of the individual alpine skiing events on the Olympic slope in Hafjell. 62 starters, two ski runs ahead of them. The question among the athletes, could anyone stop River Radamus of the USA from winning his fourth gold medal at the Youth Olympic Games? From the off, it was clear the course itself was to be the big test. Icy and challenging, the slightest mistake, and that was that. All eyes were on Norway's Odin Vassbotten Breivik. The home nation has had little success to cheer about on the Olympic slope so far. Breivik was to change all that with a faultless run. Putting his local knowledge to the good, crossed the line in the lead with a time of 49.64. Sweden's Philip Wennerström had watched it all closely. The course could be mastered with concentration and fluency. The conditions were tough, but the Swede was in total control of his skis. The run was good, and the clock showed he couldn't have been closer. It moved him into second place, 1/100th of a second behind the leader. It was then the turn of the three-time gold medalist himself. Could he do it again? Nothing wrong with the start from River Radamus, faultless. But then, the slope took its revenge.
Out of three possible.
River was down, drained, and out. Understandably angry, he raced away in frustration, but it wasn't long before the smile was back. Meanwhile, Austria's Manuel Tranninger felt he hadn't delivered his best skiing so far. Pleased with his silver in the combined and bronze in the Super G, he said he knew he could do better. His first run was promising, 49.94, which put him in third place. So at the halfway stage, Norway's Breivik was in front, Sweden's Wennerström was right behind, and Tranninger of Austria was third fastest. But the course was the real winner, with no fewer than 20 runners failing to finish. What was in store for the all-important second run?
Racing towards the finish
the slalom
line.
Is physically demanding. Watch Moritz Opetnik of Austria. He clocked the fastest time of the second run before collapsing in a heap. He was okay, just exhausted.
Ahead from the first run and increased to 8200.
So this was the moment for Manuel Tranninger. He needed to close a gap of 3/10 of a second and then post a finish time for the others to chase. Not easy to do on a brute of a course. He found the speed and was soon ahead of the clock at every section. This is what he'd tried to do all week. As he crossed the line, his time of 1:38.74 was way out in front. He knew he couldn't have done any better and enjoyed the moment. Sweden's Philip Wennerström was a blink of an eye behind the leader after the first run. His goal now was to match the speed of Tranninger. The timings were neck and neck through the sections. There was really nothing in it. It was an error-free run, and only the clock would split them. 1:38.77, he was behind Tranninger by 300th of a second. So now this was Norway's chance to have a local skier on the podium for the first time in the alpine skiing. And Odin Vassbotten Breivik started his run fastest of all. It put him ahead in section one and maintained his leading position. But as he passed through section two, he started to fall behind. He pushed again, but as he crossed the line, his combined time of 1:40.07 was 1.33 seconds off the lead to drop him down to third place. It meant Manuel Tranninger claimed the gold for Austria, Philip Wennerström the silver medal for Sweden, a mere 300th of a second behind. And Odin Vassbotten Breivik was in the bronze position for Norway. The smile was brought from Traninger, delighted with his golden moment at last. Wennerström was pleased with his silver. And despite dropping back to third, Breivik was delighted to bring home success for Norway. You now have a bronze, a silver and the gold. What does that mean to you?
It's great. I think when I can make one medal, it's great, but three, it's great. My trainer motivated me. He said to me, I can win this race, and yeah, I won.
I would like to have gold for going for the gold, but it's great. It's an acknowledgement for that you are good in skiing, and yeah, I'm really satisfied.
I'm feeling fantastic. It was really, really fun to ski, and it was cool. And when the skiing is good, I'm happy as well. So it's always fun to win a bronze medal, and of course, it's cool.